the point to the manufacturers, so the manufacturers refrained from cutting their prices because they wanted to capture lost margins of the past year. So now these manufacturers are coming out to say that, okay, in the coming months of July, August, and till the end of the year, we are going to see a tapering in these prices because we have finally come to a level where we can say, okay, we can cut prices because we've captured some of our lost margins of 2016.
Is that what the survey is showing?
No, the survey is a word on the street. So the survey is a historical, inflation is a historical indicator. So now we're looking at inflation expectations and the future. And yes, from what we can hear, we see that
the most likely manufacturers or producers of goods are saying, moving forward, they may begin to trim prices
a little bit by the side.
And that would be very interesting. If we put that back on the screen, I don't mind the price of bread, sugar, maybe soft drink. I've been told to stay away from that. Everyone's been told. But yeah, we still consume it once in a while. Those prices can get a little bit trimmed from the months forward. Yes. Now we're getting into the planting season with a heavy rainfall. And all of that, will this be part of the considerations for inflation expectations?
Yes, they will be. So as we are actually in the planting season at the moment, and now we are approaching the harvest season. So the shortages that usually characterize this season would start to disappear. And so you start seeing increased output, given that all things are equal. So if there's no shock to the structural environment or in the global environment, as we are seeing with oil prices, and we know that oil prices affect our forex receipts and our fiscal earnings. So if there's no distortion in the global market, if there's little to no distortion in the oil markets, then all other things being equal,
When you folks sit together with your research team and others, what do you see as the top three risks in the second half?
Yes. Okay. So I'm sure the public is aware that the federal government came out to say that they were about to restructure and securitize their debts to the tune of 2.7 trillion naira. So that, and also coupled with increased budget disbursements, are going to affect the level of money supply in the market. So, and we know there's a relationship between money supply and price stability. So if we see increased money supply, then that could alter the trend of inflation that we see at the moment. So and then we also look at the minimum wage review that is still ongoing. So in the off chance that they come to a conclusion and accept the terms on ground, we'll see increased demand pull pressures on prices as people will see an increase in their purchasing power due to the increase in minimum wage. And also, finally, a third risk will be also the risk in the oil market. So
yes, risk in the oil market. But again, if there's more money supply because of the securitization of the bonds and the promissory notes, of course the finance chief says we want to bring in more liquidity into the marketplace. Mm-hmm. Again, at the same time, you're spending massively on both the recurrent expenditure, which is salaries and wages, and you're pumping about 2 trillion into this budget, which we're not too sure what the lifespan really is in practical terms, whether it's going to be 6 months or run into 2018, which means there's going to be a heavy rainfall of cash in the system.
Yes.
Then, of course, you expect Gordon Emefiele and his team to come in with the mops, isn't it?
Yes, exactly.
Are we going to mop it up? And that, again, that brings us to the doorstep of how much of this will flow into the manufacturing, whatever sector, to engineer production that will really help tame inflation.
Yes, exactly. So,
these are the downside risks.
Yes, these are the downside risks, and you said it all. So, so this will also factor into, like the previous guest said, what the Monetary Policy Committee is going to consider in making their decisions. And like he said, we also expect that the MPC would hold on rates or maintain the status quo at the moment because they have these considerations on ground. So the anticipated increase in money supply, the possible external shocks from the global market. So these will all feed into what the MPC considers.
I was just about to ask for your vote for the next MPC next week. What's your take?
Yes, like I said, we expect that they would hold on key policy parameters.
You analysts seem to think almost along the same wavelength all the time when it comes to this, that the central bank will do nothing next week.
Yes. So
what do you think the key consideration will be, or what do you think they should think, they should focus on?
Yeah, so obviously their mandate is price stability. So they'll be looking at the current inflation numbers. They'll also be looking at growth projections. They'll also be looking at events in the external markets in making their decisions.
The current inflation level is way, way out of this world, at variance with what the central bank want. 9% was the headroom.
Yes, now, their target is 11% by year end. So 16.1 is still well above that target. So
yes,
that is also going to factor into their consideration.
No one knows what's, we have about three more MPCs before the end of the year.
Yes.
Okay. So that means that we'll likely see interest rates decline in 2017.
Yes, so at the start of the year, they came out and they said, we're going to consider a more accommodative monetary policy environment, so interest rate environment, so that would be cutting rates to also help with the economic growth plans. So obviously inflation is going down now, so that should also aid the doves in the monetary policy committee.
Maybe that's going to come in December.
Yes,
maybe that's going to be what you call the end of year bonus.
Treats, yes.
Yeah, for everyone.
Yes.
So we're going to keep that in the can for Godwin Emefiele and the rest of his team on the MPC. Thank you very much, Amaka Ajegu, for coming. We appreciate that from Financial Derivatives Company. Of course, the the market is at a pre-open level, so we're going to get to have a little bit of that later on the show today. But don't forget, the big story is around Skybank announcing plans for a recapitalization. Says it's got in various options. They've appointed a financial advisor, who's an investment bank, to take it through that process, and has been submitted those proposals, options proposals, to the Central Bank of Nigeria. We'll be right back in 2 minutes.